Alrighty, welcome back to New Record Day. My name is Ron. Good to see you guys, and I am excited to be able to do this one. All right, so sound clips with commentary, Polk L800s. We're gonna have some fun. And before we get started, a couple of things. The Polk L800s are a really interesting speaker. And look, miking any speaker is problematic. And so with SDA being taken into account, that's a technology that these speakers have, and we'll be talking about this more when we get to the review. This is going to be interesting as to how this all sounds and if you guys can make out anything that I'm hearing in room. And that is what makes the sound clips with commentary unique. This is not just a sound demo. I am here as your tour guide. So hands in the bus at all times. Don't get too crazy. I am going to walk you guys through everything that I'm hearing in the room, and you guys are hanging out with me and we're listening together. On deck, we have the Ineos Zenith. We have the Holo Medac, which is, holy smokes, that's a nice sounding DAC. And then we have the Marantz Model 30 and the big boys, the Polk L800s. This video is being sponsored. Folks, Safe and Sound is, they've been amazing to work with, and I am so grateful for the fact that they are sponsoring this video. They do carry the Polk L800s. They do carry the Marantz Model 30. So you guys can, you know, check that out if you guys want. I'm not here to sell you anything. The cool thing about them sponsoring this particular video series with the Polk L800s is, well, that gives me some freedom. I'm not so worried about monetizing this video. So guess what? You guys benefit. You guys win, because we're going to now listen to real music, not these cheesy little clips that I get from Epidemic Sound. So guys, join me in thanking Safe and Sound for sponsoring this video and making this happen. We are going to have a lot of fun, and thanks to them, we're going to be able to play some awesome music out of the L800s. All right, so before we get started, I want to talk about placement. The Polk L800s, they're going to be a little bit closer to each other than what you would normally see. So the equilateral triangle, not a good idea with the L800s. They need to be a little bit closer to each other. As a frame of reference, I'm 9 feet away from this spot right here. And from this spot, front of the baffle, center of the speaker, to here is 7 feet. So that kind of gives you a rough idea. So they need to be closer to each other. I set these up using lots, and I started basically on that 1/3 track, you know, the inside track that we do when we lay down, you know, the tracks for lots. And then from there, I just started listening and positioning them from there. I have them from the front of the baffle to the back wall. They're like 5 feet, 9 inches. So it kind of gives you, you know, a rough idea as to how far out in the room they are. Yeah, let's party. Let's have some fun. All right, so we are going to be playing a lot of fantastic music, stuff that I have been discovering recently and just having a blast with. So anything that I'm playing, I'm going to try to leave, you know, up on the screen so you guys know what we're actually, you know, listening to, and you can check it out. And here we go. First track. Thank you. one of the things that I like about what they've done here with the Polk L800s and this SDA technology is it is an effect, okay? No getting around it, it's an effect. But it doesn't, to me at least, sound gimmicky. It doesn't sound like, you know, you remember the old school, you know, AV receivers that we had when Dolby Pro Logic came out and you had like the different settings for hall reverb, you know, and it was just like this big cavernous, crazy sound. It sounded terrible. That's not what we're dealing with. And this particular song illustrates that, that yes, there is some stuff that the SDA is doing that's just kind of shooting off some interesting content off to the right and off to the left, but it still sounds natural. It sounds real. It doesn't sound, you know, cheesy or effect-like. So it has that going on. Maybe it's the resonance of the body or the reverb in the recording. I'm not really positive, but there's just some stuff, some sparkle that is shooting off that it's hard to get that without SDA. There's just some effects and some things that are happening that is being showcased that it's pretty remarkable. And when you hear it in the room, you're like, man, that sounds really cool. These are a lot of fun. That is going to be the theme of today's Sound Clips with Commentary, is these are a lot of fun. All right, so this is from Endless Field, Alive in the Wilderness, and the track is Dust. I believe all of this is recorded outside. This is beautiful. There are going to be some tracks where SDA really shows up, and this is one of those tracks. So when I was trying to get your attention, I was, you know, pointing over here. Man, there's some stuff on this track that, first of all, I'm a sucker for. Any kind of this, like, percussive type hand slaps and congos and bongos and, you know, anything like that, it just... I love it, especially like the deep bass hits and things that are happening. And I have no idea what instruments are being used in this track, and I don't really give a rip, but I'm telling you right now, there was some stuff that was being played that was beyond my walls. Like it's just out in the ether. It's like, how is that? I mean, it breaks your brain when you hear it, because you're like, how is that It's like this. SDA takes a look at your room, takes a look at your walls, and says, yeah, that's cute. We won't need that. And it just plays outside of it. It's like, wow, that is mind-bending. It's so crazy. So there's going to be some tracks where SDA shows up and brings on the fireworks, and it's like, what? Holy smokes. But at the same time, it doesn't really sound gimmicky to me. It sounds like this track is asking for that type of atmospheric type thing being thrown around. It seems like this track wants that to happen. And so, depending on the music, depending on what you're listening to, it works, man. And it works. It works good. And these are more fun than a barrel of monkeys. Holy smokes. All right, let's move on. All right, so a couple of things on this track. First and foremost, bass on the Polk L800s, it's tricky to get it to sound perfect. And in my room, I can't quite do it without the help of Dirac. I'm not running Dirac in this demo, and I did that intentionally because I want you to hear these really bring punch to the party. My goodness sakes. I mean, they knock the door down to the party when it comes to bass, and it is rather easy to end up with more than what you need. I can't stress this enough. These are big speakers, and they will absolutely produce a lot of powerful bass. You cannot toss these in your bedroom. I'm sorry. You will have to give these room to breathe. Even still on that track, I don't know if you guys are gonna be able to hear it. Bass can be a little bit bloated, a little bit muddy. I don't think it's the fault of the speakers. I think that I just have a little bit too much to work with, and something like Dirac would probably clean that up in a quick hurry and make it a little bit more concise. Bass on any speaker with ports and a box sealed, it doesn't matter. Guys, this is why I keep talking about open baffle, is the bass is gonna be always difficult to get perfect. and you might not ever get it perfect, and that's just the way things are. With that being said, even though some of the lowest of those notes can get a little bit lost, a little bit smeared, a little bit muddy or bloated, everything mid-band and above, I think, sounds excellent. And we do have polypropylene woofers here, and we are extracting some texture and tone. It doesn't hold a candle to some of the paper cone offerings that we've heard in terms of texture and tone, and just really hearing the resonance of that upright and hearing the way the wood actually sounds as it, you know, creates and crafts that note. You're not going to get that with the Polk L800s. This is more of like that kind of home theater effect type bass, where it's like, and literally I could feel like the couch shaking. It's like rattling my spine, like, ugh. It's that kind of bass. And so that's fun. And I think that it does add to the effect of what these speakers are doing to begin with. So that works. Just know, I'm getting long-winded, but just know this. The bass is hard to get perfect on the L800s. And it's going to be a challenge for a lot of you guys. Mammal Hands, Captured Spirits. And the track is Versus Shapes. Love that track, by the way. Beautiful. The whole album is awesome. You guys should definitely check this one out. What's happening with this piano played in this is it's beyond the realm of the room. It's like back here. And this is really where these speakers do some really interesting things in the music. And it's just so much fun because you're hearing things in a different light. Everything that is front and center, it is focused, right? And so we have, you know, these congas or bongos or whatever that instrument is. It's that percussive instrument that's being played, hand slaps and things like that. It is precise, and you get that. And so you're drawn into that, and you have, obviously, I believe it's a saxophone. You guys, correct me if I'm not a jazz expert, so pardon me, but I think that's a sax playing. And with all of this kind of being front and center, you almost forget about the fact that this piano is just like, it's so beyond the room that you're just kind of like, wow, the distance and separation. SDA can do some really cool things, and I would imagine that if I set up something like the Sapphires or the Auticas, I think that I would be able to walk away saying, okay, clearly that was an effect, not a gimmicky effect, but an effect. And this is probably truer to life, truer to what the musicians were hearing when they were sitting in the, you know, mixing room and they're cutting everything down and figuring it out. It's probably closer to that. But I have a feeling at the same time that if those musicians and the artists sat down and heard this, they would probably say, wow, that's really freaking cool. And that's what I'm going to say. It's really freaking cool. Might not be totally true to the artist intent. Might not be, maybe, but it's still really fun. All right, let's keep going.
I am not afraid of anything in this world. There's nothing you can throw at me that I haven't already heard. I'm just trying to find a decent melody, a song that I can sing in my own company. I never thought you were a fool.
This was the very first track that I heard Rocky Mountain Audio Fest years ago. I was with Joe from Joe and Tell, and this track on the L800s in that room, it jacked me up. Now, the guys from Sound United, they've been telling this fib, this complete and total lie about Ron was crying. I had really bad allergies that day, so I wasn't crying. And there was some guy in the back cutting onions in the kitchen. So this track, when it starts with this guy, the very first vocalist that starts, I remember that when I heard these at Rocky Mountain Audio Fest, he was like hanging out back by some trees. You know, there's like these fake plants in the hotel room, and they had one of the suites, they had one of the big rooms, it was a nice room, and I was just like, come on out over here, dude, hang out with us. And in my room, he is back behind my stereo rack. I have two stereo racks, this one over here, back behind it, and it's just like, hey, bro, you don't need to hide, come on out, I'll make an espresso. Can listen to music with us. The effect of SDA with this track being so stripped down, it's just vocals, it is astonishing because even though he is back and out of reach, it's not gimmicky sounding. It's not like, it's like a warped, weird, phasey thing. Like, that sounds strange. You know, he sounds plastered up against the wall. No, it's like he sounds real, but he's back out of reach. And it's just such a crazy, crazy effect. So once again, this is where SDA does some pretty astonishing things, and it can be just so much fun. And let's get this part right. Everybody else in the mix sounds really clean. They just don't have quite the same distance as the first singer, but in any event, they all have positioning in the soundstage, and I'm not going to go as far as to say that I can make the Polk L800s totally vanish and totally disappear. I haven't been able to do that completely. Any of the stuff that they are playing within the realm of SDA, good luck, Chuck, trying to track that coming from the speaker. It's not going to happen. It is way outside of the realm of the speaker. I think that most of the stuff that I'm hearing from the stereo image coming at me, there's times where I'm like, yeah, it's coming from the speaker. It's coming from the speaker. So there is that. But because the tonal balance of the speaker seems to be pretty dang good, I'm not drawn to a tweeter because the tweeter is squawking at me. I will say this, in terms of their tonal footprint, I do think that they do ride the edge of detail retrieval. I think that these are not a warm sounding speaker. They are also not what I would describe as a smooth sounding speaker. These are more about unpacking details and pulling the details out of the music. So if that's not your cup of tea, then yeah, I just saved you $6,000. Matthews, Some Devil. Love this track. It's stripped down. It's just Dave, and he's got a baritone guitar and drenched in reverb. And so you've got a big room effect going on here. And again, this is where SDA takes that big room sound and just, it pushes it to the max. It says, we're gonna show off how big this can actually sound. That's not necessarily why I like this track and why I wanted to showcase this track on the L800s is as a potential criticism, potential because I'm not positive about this yet, I think there are times where the center image might be sacrificed with SDA. I think, and I'm not sure about it, but if I listen to this same track with the Sapphires or the Auticas, his voice is suspended, it is holographic, it's like I can just reach out. It's as if he has just stepped up to the mic and he's singing. With these, I'm not getting that same effect. It's almost as if some of that is lost in exchange for, holy smokes, we got this cavernous room and things being thrown around and little reverb trails and, you know, the sound of the delay from the strings. He's got like a little, probably a delay on the guitar or whatever, but little things that are just happening. It seems like there's a sacrifice with that center image. I'm not positive yet, but I think I'm onto something. So let's move on. Thank you. crazy, completely insane. This type of stuff where in the music we already have some effects in the music, so from an artistic standpoint, they're using some kind of synthy type drones and some cool little effects going on. Man, there are times in this track where it sounds like there's something back up over here. I mean, it's like that is, we've entered the realm of almost like listening to speakers and headphones at the same time, where you're getting some stuff like outside of your head or in your head and in the room at the same time. This is where, like, if this is the type of music that you listen to and that's the kind of stuff that you want out of music, then, well, these very well could be endgame for you, because they do some wicked, crazy things in terms of this sort of, oh man, there was a part where this like drone-y type synth is going on, and it sounds like it's swirling outside of the listening room altogether. It's almost as if everything just disappeared and we just have this drone-y type thing while the rest of the band is just hanging out in here. And then there's this funky type effect thing going on just outside of my head to the left side. These 3D type atmospheric type effects in this music with SDA, that is, man, that is the ingredients for holy smokes party time. This is where the L800s really show off. Like, yeah, we can do this all day long. This track is amazing. It's one of my favorites, and this is one of my go-to tracks when I'm setting up speakers. There's some really cool atmospheric type effects going on with this, and this track will help you determine whether or not your speakers are far enough out into the room. Because if you're not hearing some real depth and spatial cues in this track, then you need to bring your speakers out in the room. With the L800s, it does push the envelope on this track. You know, it's like, if I have the Sapphires in here or the Anexoticas in here, it's playing the layering, the depth, the width, it's doing all of that, and it does it extremely well. These will push just past that outer boundary. It's like it takes it another foot or two past that, and it's a cool effect. It's a lot of fun. I am kind of back to my, I guess, my suspicion that with her vocals, with pretty much any speaker that's not the L800s, I feel like she has more of a holographic nature to her voice, and with the L800s, I'm not quite getting that. It feels like it's maybe a little bit flatter than what it normally is, so there is a trade-off. It's like, do you want that extra wow, holy smokes, and are you willing to sacrifice what's happening right in the middle to get that? I think that's what I'm starting to notice more and more as I'm making my way through with the L800s. Lane Staley, rest in peace. Jerry Cantrell, some of the best harmonies ever. Like, so good. I love this album. I love listening to this album. And one of the things that's interesting about SDA is when it decides to show up. And this was one of the albums where I kind of expected, like, the floodgates to open and I'm in the performance or I'm in the crowd and there's going to be people cheering all around me and all that kind of stuff. No, not at all. Actually, it's rather tame, and it's really interesting when and why SDA shows up and does some interesting things. I would imagine that a lot of it has to do with when they're mixing things down in the studio, what's being hard panned left and right and what's not. I'm sure a lot of that has to do with the stereo effects that you end up with. But on this track, going from the L800s to the Sapphires or the Anexoticas or whatever speaker, pick any speaker, it's surprising to me that you might wonder, is SDA even working? Like, what the heck is going on? So there's some tracks where, and that's why I'm playing this track, is you really don't get that big atmospheric type thing at all, actually. It just doesn't seem like it exists. And then there are some, like from track to track, where it's like, holy cow, that is crazy. That is insane. So keep that in mind. It's worth noting. Thank you.
tasted sweet. Finally I can breathe again, finally I can speak. I've got you in the glory bliss, I've got you way down deep. I've got you way down, way, way down, way, way down deep. You've got me way down, way, way down, way, way down deep. You've got me way down deep. I wander with you in my sleep. I'm way down, way, way down, way, way down deep.
I first heard this track at Danny's place, Danny from GR Research, and heard it on the In Extremes with the triple open baffle subs. That's the best that I've ever heard this song by far. On his rig and his room, it blew my mind. With the Polk L800s, and I want to make sure that I drive this point home, everything that is big about this recording, even in my smaller room than what Danny has, actually sounds bigger than what I remember hearing it in Texas. This sounds huge. There's stuff that is just being thrown around the room that is just, it's beyond comprehension. And I know for a fact that's what the SDA is doing. And yet, I still come back to his room, the In Extremes, his gear being the pinnacle of how I've heard this song. And there's two reasons why. Even though this is giving me what I genuinely believe is a bigger presentation of the entire soundstage, her voice is what's really missing in this equation. It's good. Actually, it's better than good. It's excellent. But with his, she is suspended, holographic. I swear to you that it was one of those times where I'm like, she's right there. I can see her. And with this, you're not quite getting that same effect. And the bass. The bass on the Polk L800s, like I said before, and I'm sure in this recording, some of these guys are, you know, and by the way, please wear headphones. I'm so sick and tired of these knuckleheads that show up. They're like, yeah, it sounds just like my computer speakers. It's like, put on a pair of headphones. The bass on the Polk L800s with my Earthworks QTC40s, and I'm recording onto an F8N field recorder. I'm using some very good recording gear. I can promise you that this is gonna rattle some of your cans. Like, wow, the bass is crazy on these. And in Rome, it is. But when you hear that deep, powerful bass on triple open baffle subs, tuned perfectly to the room, game over. Checkmate. Shut the front door. It's not even on the same planet. And I'm not trying to poo-poo the L800's bass performance. It's powerful. And it's got that chest-pumping kind of visceral, real, wow, jackhammer bass. But man, when you hear the way that is supposed to really sound, where it's just hit and then gone, and you're just left with the resonance of the hit, there's nothing that touches it. There's nothing that comes close to it. So bass performance, I think that most people hearing this for the very first time would probably pick this room and this seat and these as the best they've ever heard this song, because they're going to be hearing, wow, this is larger than life and la, 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 all this stuff. But I'm sitting here going, yeah, but that bass can be better. It can be cleaner. It can be cleaned up. You're not going to get the room boom at all. And you're actually missing out on some of the details in the bass fundamentals, the structure, the resonance, the decay structure in the bass. You're missing some of that with these because you just have this boom, you know? So keep that in mind. And then also holographic center image. Reach out and touch. So, yeah. All right. Moving on, the Tel Aviv session. Oh, the very first song that I ever heard on the Spatial Sapphires, Aswade. If you guys have not heard this album, everything you're doing today is less important than listening to this entire album. I just want you to know that because it's so good. All right. I'm a sucker for everything that is being played on this track. We have stripped down acoustic guitar, and then we have this percussive type section that is playing alongside it, all these little clacks and clicks and little details. It's like a chance for DK to jump off of everything that is being played in this track. And when you have speakers pulled out in the room, using lots, of course, then you're able to follow along with all of these little intricate details. I'm gonna make a point here. Even though that is brand spanking new, that Holo Maydac, I just recently reviewed the Terminator. This is showing me some stuff in the recordings that I've been missing out on. It's stunning. And the good news is that it's cheaper than the Terminator. So if you want to know right up front, right out of the gates, I think we got a winner on our hands. Like a genuine winner-winner chicken dinner with that DAC. Because does it sound analog all day long? And it is revealing some stuff that has been lost in the music. And so, however it is putting that puzzle piece back together again, I think that it might be doing a better job than any DAC that I have ever heard so far on my journey. Now, in terms of all of the details, spatial cues, DK structure, all of that stuff, love what the Polk L800s are doing on this track. When it comes to the bass, not as good as the Sapphires. It's just not. It's not as clean. It's not as accurate sounding. It's not as quick to respond. And you know what? This is not the fault of the Polk L800s. No box speaker can match open baffle bass. I will never say anything different, guys, just so you know. So if you're waiting for me to say, hey, we got a unicorn on our hands, it will never happen, because it can't. You can't get open baffle speed, dynamics, clarity, resolution out of boxes. So there's that. What's interesting about the Polk L800s with this track is, once again, if I swapped this out and took away the bass element, I think I might have a hard time telling am I hearing the Sapphires or I'm hearing the Polk L800s? That is a good thing, and that what that tells me is that even though we have this SDA effect being taken into account, I don't think that it is doing anything so bizarre that it is ruining the integrity of the song. And that's what I mean by, if I was to swap these out, sure, there's going to be some tone differences and things like that, but in terms of where things sit and how things are being presented, I feel like it's, they're both paying respect to the integrity of the song. And once again, we're kind of back to, well, where the heck is the SDA in this track? Because I'm not hearing anything shooting off to the sides or anything like that. So SDA is interesting in that there's going to be some times where it shows up and it does some amazing things, and there's going to be some times where it's just chill. Yoshi Horikawa, track is Bubbles. This is just so much fun. Ladies and gentlemen, if there is anybody out there that decides to buy the Polk L800s, this is the track that you should play on them first. If you want to know in a quick hurry, where did my $6,000 go? Where did it take me? Try Bubbles. Try that track. Make sure your speakers are set up correctly. Use LOTS, for crying out loud. Don't be a knucklehead. And mind-altering experience. Stuff being played in a dimension that just no other speaker can quite do that. They can't do that. And it will jack you up in a quick hurry. It really will. So much fun. Like I said, Polk L800s might be sacrificing the center image, depending on the recording. That's me trying to be fair and balanced in the review. Bass is going to be difficult to get perfect. Big factor there. Biggest factor there is going to be your room and how you handle that. And the SDA effect, I'm a big fan. It's fun. It is more fun than a barrel of monkeys. That's my thoughts on the Polk L800s. If I was doing like a, here's what I would do. This is like, let's just daydream as if we had all the money in the world, and we don't. But Sapphires and Exoticas for two channel everyday listening, done. They're my favorites, right? So that's that. If I had a separate home theater-ish type room where I was doing home theater, these would be my mains. Get a center channel, some surround sound speakers, and I would do movies with these, and then I would come in here and I would play Bubbles. I'm kidding. It's not the only song that I would play, but what I want to just have fun and just listen to some fun freaking effects that will just break your brain and just make you go, what? That's what I would do. That's what I would do. So now's a good time to mention Patreon. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. All right, guys. Appreciate it. And we'll see you guys in the next video.